Hi, the fifth semester. Father Joby here. Happy to come over for this class. We are going to do today something on love for our nation, patriotism, love for the country, India. I'm sure in the first year and the second year, we have done something prior to the Independence Day, making us feel a bit more proud to be an Indian. If there are students of other nations, here is a chance for you to feel and know a little more of this great country called India. And as you love your nation, we are here to feel and be proud of this great nation called India. When you think about our nation, what comes to your mind? A sense of negativity or things positive? I'm sure looking through the eye of brightness and light, we see more great things around. There are things to be improved. There are things that need to change. But I'm sure we as a nation and as Indians, each of us have a role to contribute to it. Here is a popular clipping from a famous movie. I'm sure this will speak a few things about this great nation called India. Yes, Indians, I'm sure we feel proud and feel great that we belong to this big and a nation of unity and respect. And here are some more things that we need to know, that this nation called India prides itself in rich, varied, but wants to keep and remain always united. May this inspire us.
In the year of 1947, the British decided to leave India, but just before they packed their bags, they had made India bleed even more by pushing it into a deadly civil war. Who would have thought at that time that just in a few decades, Indian companies would be buying and taking over the top British brands like Jaguar, Range Rover, or the famous tea brand that we know as Stepley? Who would have imagined that an Indian brand, Tata, would buy a steel company, Coros, and provide jobs to the British in their own land, but without making it a colony? Actually, I will not be very surprised if this video will shock the international community a bit. When you hear the word India, the images that come to your mind are something like this. When the media in your country talks about India, they show you clips like this. But what they are not showing you, and what they are actually hiding from you, is that India also looks like this. Who could have thought a few decades earlier that the British government would be panicking and calling a special session of parliament when an Indian company, Tata, would decide to sell their brand Coros, which would be making thousands of British jobless? Who could have thought that in just a few decades after the independence from the British, an Indian company, Tata, would actually become the biggest private sector employer of the UK? It took just a few decades for the Indians to show what they were capable of, and all of this was done in a complete fair business environment, not by colonizing, looting, and killing as the British did. And I am not talking about just one Indian brand. Today, there are many brands and individuals from India who are creating huge business empires on the land of the UK. But Indians are not here to take any revenge or prove a point. They are just doing what they have been always good at. And that is not just yoga, Ayurveda, or IT. Indians, who are the masters of spirituality, are also masters in business. Indian economy has finally gained momentum. And mind you, It has not got to the fifth gear yet. Probably it is still in the second gear, but what is surprising that even in the second gear, it has already become the fastest growing major economy in the world, already taking over China in that regard. And India still has so much of unutilized potential which is lying in its reserves. Now let's talk about the major industries of India. IT sector. India is the world's largest sourcing destination for the information technology industry, accounting for approximately 67% of the $124 to $130 billion market. India ranks third among global startup ecosystems with more than 4,200 startups. Science and technology. India, a country which is a nuclear power, also ranks third among the most attractive investment destinations for technology transactions in the world. The Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, has completed its mission of developing India's independent navigation system by launching Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, which means India has its own version of what in the West we know as GPS. India is constantly helping other countries like Singapore, Germany, UK, and many more to launch their satellites as well. It has successfully undertaken space mission to Moon and even Mars. Pharmaceuticals sector. The Indian pharmaceuticals market is the third largest in the world in terms of volume, and India is the largest provider of generic drugs. Gems and jewelry sector. India is one of the largest exporters of gems and jewelry in the world. They are a hub of semi-precious and precious stones. How many of you actually knew that 95% of diamonds in the world are cut, polished, and processed in India? And most of it happens in just one city of India, that is called Surat. Healthcare sector. India is fast becoming a hub of medical tourism of both types of healthcare, modern medicine and natural, which includes Ayurveda and other natural treatments. It has the advantage of the new state-of-art hospitals and well-trained and high-skilled professionals, which is supplemented by its low cost. The cost of surgery in India is about 1/10 of what in the US or Western Europe. India is a top destination for you, whether it's about natural treatments, a heart surgery, a cosmetic surgery, or a dental treatment, which your country's natural insurance may not be covering. Real estate sector. India is building future cities of the world with a massive plan of building 100 smart cities. To give you an example, over 5 million homes are under construction just in the National Capital Region of India. A majority of people in India still live in villages, and India is preparing itself for the biggest migration of its people from villages to the cities, at a scale which the mankind has probably never seen before. Infrastructure sector. India is growing its infrastructure at an unbelievable speed. Did you know that its capital already has around 250 kilometers of modern metro rail? And it's going to add a few hundreds more, which is going to make it the biggest in the world, close to Shanghai. Almost all its major cities are seeing the rapid development of metro, and the construction of bullet trains connecting the major cities are underway too. Not just that, India is developing infrastructure in the other parts of the world and growing its influence by making ports and developing other mega infrastructure outside India too. Automobile sector. Apart from all the international companies which are lining up to make the most of India's automobile market, which is literally exploding, India's own brands are not far behind. From the premium brands of Jaguar and Range Rover to the cheapest car, Tata Nano, India has it all. You will be surprised to know that India has a long list of its own automobile brands like Mahindra, Hero, TVS, Ashok Leyland, Bajaj, Force Motors, Eicher, just to name a few. Hero is the world's largest manufacturer of two-wheelers. Mahindra are another big name who were very close to the acquisition of Alfa Romeo a while ago. Agriculture sector. India is the largest producer, consumer and exporter of spices and spice products. It is also the source of the delicious mangoes, pulses and famous basmati rice that is known for its taste and fragrance around the world. The good news is that the northeast part of India has its agriculture based on the traditional organic farming, which has been untouched by the failed scientific experiments of fertilizers and genetic seed modification. How many of you actually knew that India, which is nearly half in area of China and the US, actually has more arable land than China and is second largest in the world, only marginally behind the US? Also, other sectors of India are worth a mention here, such as cement industry, which is the second largest in the world. Also, India is growing rapidly in biotechnology, aviation, banking and insurance, film industry, media and entertainment, and many more. It is also a big exporter of textiles, which includes finest silk, pashmina, leather and marble. Besides, how many of you actually knew that some of the top brains in the world are either Indian nationals or of Indian origin? Sundar Pichai, an Indian who has studied in the Indian Institute of Technology, is now the CEO of Google. Satya Nadella, who is the CEO of Microsoft, is a graduate from Manipal Institute of Technology in India. The CEO of Aerobi Systems is also an Indian and his name is Shantanu Narayan. And these are just a few names. There is a long list of global CEOs from India. So no matter where you are in the world, whatever country you may belong to, whether you are a young boy or a girl in a primary school or a college, you must know that sooner or later you will have to have something to do with India. And it is inevitable because India is fast establishing itself as a top 3 economy of the world and its true potential is even bigger than that. So it's better that you start educating yourself about the rising economic powerhouse that we know as India, because your future belongs here too. And as I have said earlier, India is not just developing. India is reclaiming. See you again.
Friends, another thing where India has put its clear mark and place defined itself is in the space technology. Here are a few achievements of India's space organization, the ISRO. May we be proud that we stand tall in many areas and even in the field of science. Have a look at this and I'm sure we feel second to none.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Top 10 biggest achievements of ISRO. Number 10, Aryabhat. The Aryabhat was India's first satellite, named after an Indian astronomer. It marked a milestone in India's space program because it was completely designed in the country and launched from a Russian facility in 1975. It was built to gain experience in building and operating a satellite in space. Number 9, Indian National Satellite System. The Indian National Satellite System, popularly known as INSAT, is a series of multi-purpose geostationary satellites launched by ISRO to satisfy the telecommunications, broadcasting, meteorology, and search and rescue operations. Commissioned in 1983, INSAT is the largest domestic communication system in the Asia-Pacific region. Number 8, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. It was developed in the 1990s and has become the Indian space mission's most reliable workhorse. The PSLV carried out its first mission in 1993, but its first successful outing was the next year. For the next 25 years, it launched various satellites for historic missions such as the Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan. PSLV remains a favorite among various organizations as a launch service provider. The PSLV system has been used 39 times for launching payload into low Earth orbit. Of these 39 launches, ISRO has suffered only one true failure, the maiden flight of the PSLV rocket in 1993. Number 7, Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle Mark 3. Taking its baby steps towards realizing India's ambition to send humans into space, ISRO has successfully tested the atmospheric re-entry of a Kuru module, after its heaviest launch vehicle GSLV Mk3 blasted off from Sriharikota. The Kuru module can carry up to 2 to 3 astronauts, withstood a heat of around 1,600 degrees Celsius. By 2020, India is expected to enter the special group of space cruising nations that are capable of taking people to space. Number 6, Reusable Launch Vehicle TD. In May 2016, ISRO successfully tested the Reusable Launch Vehicle Technology Demonstrator. The technology, when developed completely, would launch spacecraft including satellites into space and re-enter the Earth's atmosphere withstanding extreme pressure and heat conditions and land in an intended spot, helping to cut costs on launch vehicles substantially. Number 5, Launching 20 Satellites in a Single Flight. In June 2016, the ISRO launched 20 satellites in one mission, a record for the space agency. The PSLV carried a weight of 1,288 kilograms, with India's CARTOSAT-2 series satellite taking up most of it. Apart from that, the mission carried satellites from the US, Canada, Germany and Indonesia. Number 4, Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System. IRNSS is an ingeniously built constellation of 7 satellites which has been now given an operational name of NAVIC, Navigation with Indian Constellation. The satellites can provide accurate real-time positioning and timing services and extend its service to regions 1,500 kilometers around India. IRNSS satellite constellation consists of 3 satellites in GEO orbit and 4 satellites in GSO orbit, that are 36,000 kilometers above Earth's surface. Number 3, Chandrayaan. It is Indian Lunar Exploration Program. The first mission Chandrayaan 1 was launched on October 2008 on board PSLV XL rocket, and operated until August 2009. ISRO joined an elite list of just 6 space organizations to send an orbiter to the Moon. The Chandrayaan 1 mission carried Moon Impact Probe payload that made the popular discovery of water on Moon. India's second lunar mission, Chandrayaan 2, is expected to be launched in 2017. Number 2, Launching 104 Satellites from Single Rocket. ISRO creates history as PSLV launches 104 satellites in one go. Russian Space Agency held a record of launching 37 satellites at once during its mission in June 2014. The U.S. Space Agency, NASA, has launched 29. PSLV in its 39th flight, launched the 714 kg CARTOSAT-2 series satellite for Earth observation along with 103 co-passenger satellites, together weighing about 1,378 kg. Out of the total 104 satellites placed in orbit, 101 satellites belonged to 6 foreign countries. They included 96 from the US and 1 each from Israel, the UAE, the Netherlands, Switzerland and Kazakhstan. Number 1, Mangalyaan. India joined an exclusive global club when ISRO's Mars Orbiter mission, dubbed as Mangalyaan, successfully entered the Martian orbit on September 2014 in its maiden attempt. India became the first country to successfully complete maiden Mars mission and also the fourth country to successfully venture into Mars on a shoestring budget that was at least 10 times lower than a similar project by the US. The 450 crore rupees project revolved around the Red Planet to collect data on Mars' atmosphere and mineral composition.
Fine, friends. Here is something of a bit of satire. This was a cartoon that came in the New York Times back in 2014. Of course, India knocking at the doors of other elite space club. I'm sure it speaks the picture. And in 2017, we know that India launched a record of 104 satellites from many of the countries that otherwise would deny India. And that was a cartoon that appeared in the Times of India then, of course, mocking the old. I'm sure this speaks about the greatness of India, and together as a nation, together as Indians, we can make a great change. Fine. I'm sure as Indians, we have done this. This is our national anthem in the other years. Some of us who are not used to the original language, Sanskrit, Hindi words, maybe here is an explanation that we can go through. And I'm sure as proud Indians, we sing the national anthem every time when we have programs, and may we love our nation a little more. May we contribute best of ours, and as Indians, take pride and give ourselves the best. I be the change to make our nation great to the vision that all of us have. God bless you. Jai Hind. Fine. Dear friends, usually we used to end the class with the national anthem when we are here. And of course, just before the independence, it was fitting that we do this class. But here is an explanation of the national anthem that all of us as Indians with pride that we sing. To some of us who do not understand the language, here is the explanation of each line so that we understand what we sing, we feel proud of what we sing, and we pay tribute to our nation and to our anthem. May this inspire us, may this make us understand and love our nation and contribute much to our nation as Indians and make our country proud. May God bless you. Jai Hind.